ESMO 2017 is really in the light of adjuvant trials. We have now seen the data from the COMBI-AD trial, a trial testing BRAF-MEK inhibition, highly significant benefit for the patient in relapse-free survival and in overall survival. We have seen the nivolumab, the CheckMate 238 trial, nivolumab adjuvant versus ipilimumab. We have known already that ipilimumab adjuvant can improve the overall survival, and now we see a relapse-free survival benefit compared to ipilimumab. So there we have now two very promising treatments in the adjuvant setting for melanoma. It's going further. We have presented some data on the neoadjuvant treatment of stage 3 melanoma, the OPASSION trial, where we for the first time show very nice biomarkers that can discriminate patients that will not relapse versus where the group of relapses are in there. There are also some patients that have benefit, but for the non-relapse we clearly can identify them. That is the adjuvant setting. For the stage 4 disease, we have seen very promising data combinations, early phase data from IDO inhibition plus anti-PD-1. We have seen very nice data anti-LAG-3 with anti-PD-1, and we have seen also combinations from BRAF-MEK inhibition with anti-PD-1. There you can discuss whether you want to give this triple therapy continuously or intermittent. Tony Ribas presented data where this was given continuously. Very nice tumor control data, but at the cost of a lot of toxicity. We are currently performing a trial where we give this intermittent, the BRAF inhibition, in addition to the anti-PD-1 blockade. And it seems that we can achieve similar efficacy but lower toxicity. So it's a very interesting interesting congress in melanoma with many landmark trials. The COMBI-AD and the CheckMate just have been published in New England Journal of Medicine.